Hey folks, welcome back to Wisconsin Family. Justin and I have been having a ball here at Yahara Bay Distillery. And boy, we have been really excited because we know we are about to learn a whole lot about the distillation process.
And this is a unique facility, which is what gets me so excited.
Yeah, we're gonna talk a little bit about small batch distillation in just a moment. And we are joined by Nick Quint, who is the founder here, and Lars Forty, who is the lead distiller, or rather we're joining you, and we really appreciate you having us.
Our pleasure.
So thank you so much. Before we get into, we're actually going to do a little bit of a demonstration, which is exciting. But first, let's talk a little bit about Yahara Bay. If you didn't know at home, Yahara Bay was actually the first distillery in Dane County. So tell us a little bit about that and how it got started.
Well, I had no prior experience in this. I was semi-retired, kind of looking for something to do. And I heard about these. There was one other one in Wisconsin in 2007. And about 70 in the nation. Now there's 20 some in Wisconsin, about 700 in the nation.
Wow.
But I started it as just sort of a part-time thing to do, being retired.
A labor of love. Yes.
Yeah. And I relied heavily on family for volunteer work, and it evolved from there.
And look at you now.
That's incredible.
This is incredible.
Yeah.
I love that startup.
So as I look around here, you have a lot of different, you have 40 different varieties that you produce here, but there's very little automation going on. Can you talk to us a little bit about how it all gets done?
That's a good point.
Yeah, the number of products kind of got out of hand. We believed in sort of making something for everybody.
Right.
People would say, well, I'm a beer drinker or I'm a wine drinker. Well, we wanted something that would kind of fit in there and they could still come out here and have a good time. Automation is our hands. And we try not to actually get overly automated because by staying close to the product, that's part of the craft.
Right.
Hands-on, touching, smelling, tasting, and everything is single batch. There's always a little differentiation between batches.
Sure.
No matter what it is.
I think that's incredible. And we're going to learn a little bit about really what the benefits to that are, to doing the small batches, because there are a lot of benefits, as we have learned a little bit before even starting. But I had the opportunity before we started the show to kind of take a look around. And boy, you guys are bursting at the seams. You have a lot happening here. Any plans to expand?
Yes, when we started this, it was pretty much illegal to do tours and tastings and things like that in Wisconsin.
Hmm.
That's why we started this in an industrial park. Well, the law finally got changed, and we're open now Thursday nights here, but we're blowing apart at the seams. So starting late fall, we've already have construction going on at on Nesbitt Road to move the whole facility eventually over there in the fall.
That's incredible.
It's quadruple the works of the space. Mm-hmm. We'll be adding a much larger still, but we'll always keep Carl here.
Well, Carl's old faithful, right?
Yes.
You gotta have Carl. I think that's great. And I got to see kind of some of the plans, and people coming to the bar can actually see what's going on behind the scenes right as they sit there and enjoy their drink. And, and that's great.
One thing we don't wanna lose is the flavor of being able to touch, feel, see what's coming out, seeing what we're doing, not just looking through a window all the time. So.
Absolutely. Well, what an incredible startup, what an incredible story, and now here you are ready to expand as things have, just production has is booming, so I love it. And it's not mass production, it is literally the folks here bottling things by hand and doing the work as you see behind us. I love it.
Yeah. It's very cool. It's very cool. So real quick before we go on to our demonstration, if people want to see the before and after of the facilities, can people here come to Yahara Bay? Can they come here for tours and samplings now?
Yeah. We still, on Thursday nights, the public house is open to the public.
Sure.
You can go online and book tours for weekends and during the week. And we'll be doing that until the doors are unlocked at the new place, and then we'll just switch. So, yes,
it's kind
we
of
invite
a,
people.
A historic place, really. This has been here for a long time, and it's about to move and expand. So capture a little piece of history and come check it out.
Excellent. So still open to the public. You still encourage people to come. That's awesome. I want to turn to Lars real quick over here. How are you, Lars?
I'm doing great. Thank
awesome.
You.
And you're going to give us a little bit of a demonstration, or at least talk to us about what some of these gadgets.
Absolutely.
Do.
Lots of gadgets and shiny things behind us.
Yeah.
This is a Christian Carl copper pot still,
okay.
All single batch. So you did mention that we're not mass produced, which is very true. This is the unit right here that produces everything at Yahara Bay. So single batch, about 100 gallons at a time. Everything we produce runs through here. We are currently running gin right now.
All right.
So you can kind of see the whole process boiling in the pot here. It's going to rise up this column.
Wow.
The vape, just the vapors, and that's what you're seeing kind of boil back. Then the vapors are rising through these pipes, and in this bucket right here is where it's called a botanical extractor, which is fancy words for bucket, basically. And that's where all the botanicals go, the juniper, fennel, and all the stuff that we can't tell you, the secret recipe, or
you'd
have to take you out back. anyways, vapors keep flowing through these pipes over to this unit here, which is the cold water condenser.
Okay.
So it's still in vapor form at the top of this condenser, but by the time it gets to the bottom, as you can see, it's liquid, the spirit coming out at that point.
Okay.
And everything small batch, the, you know, when you know craft small batch, you think quality, which is definitely the case with spirit.
Yeah.
So what we do is have full control out of this output because we are single batch, meaning we heat up the still, charge it, get it up to temperature, run it, and then cool it down and start over.
Wow.
So we can eliminate what's called the methyl alcohol.
Oh,
over
okay.
here. This little bucket here is called heads, and we keep it around. Everything you ferment is going to produce methyl and ethyl alcohol.
Sure, yeah.
Small batch distillation, you can separate those. We're separating the methyl from the ethyl alcohol.
Okay.
If you drink really cheap vodka, you know what methyl alcohol is.
Sure.
You're going to feel it in the morning.
Yeah.
You drink methyl alcohol straight, you're going to go blind. It's probably going to drop you dead. So don't do it.
Right. No, not recommended.
We use it for
home,
cleaning
folks.
The bathroom, for sanitizing the fermenters. So forth, but that's what really creates a top shelf spirit, is separating those elements, and that's what we do here. So we've already cut the heads off this batch here, so this is called the hearts. This is what's coming out, that's the good stuff. That is the ethyl alcohol.
Okay.
So your body can break down those proteins, you can have a few cocktails and feel fine and go to work.
That's what I wanted to pause on for a moment. We've already picked your brain a little bit before we started, but I want to make sure viewers at home know that that's actually the component that gives you a hangover.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So with the cheaper liquors.
Yeah, those methyl alcohols.
Mm-hmm. They're leaving a larger percentage of that in, therefore you feel
even blending
worse.
It back to a legal allotted limit. To create a cheap product.
Right. And that's, you know, oftentimes the large batches, you know, things of that nature.
Exactly.
So that's
mass produced.
The benefits of doing small batch.
I'm just curious, how long does it take to for this,
this
to fill?
This batch is this final. Way? This is the final run for the gin. So we already had vodka as the base in the pot. This the gin takes the longest because it's running through all those botanicals.
Right,
so this
is
going to take a good 6.5 hours.
Really? To fill it. And you fill it to the top then?
Not quite, but it's going to, we'll have a little over 100 gallons in there.
Wow.
Yep.
That's impressive.
It is impressive. And I think it's really interesting to learn about some of, you know, this is one benefit of doing small batch, but other things that we talked about before we started, like seasonality of fruits. And, you know, there's all kinds of topics and interesting things that, to cover. But I appreciate
And then also working directly with those farmers, you know, the local farmers, and working with them season to season. And utilizing the fruit that might not be, you know, preferred on the table, we can still use that and turn it into spirits.
So. There's lots to learn. We could stay all day. I think we just might, but we've got to go. So thank you so much. This is Lars Forty, who is the lead distiller, and Nick Quint, of course, who is the founder here at Yahara Bay Distillery. Thanks, guys, so much for hosting
Thanks
us, having us.
Absolutely.
Greatly appreciated. We want to thank all of our guests for joining us today, and thank you for watching. Please join us next time on Wisconsin Family.
Every day is a new beginning. Shine your light. It's a day and the world is waiting.